Hello and welcome to the session. In this session, we'll discuss a question which says that a coin is tossed 3 times and all possible outcomes are assumed to be equally likely. E is the event, both head and tails have occurred, and F is the event, at most one tail has occurred. Show that events E and F are independent. Now, before starting the solution of this question, we should know a result. And that is, two events A and B are independent if probability P of event A intersection B is equal to probability of an event A into probability of an event B. Now this result will work out as a key idea for solving out the given question. Now let us start with the solution of the given question. First of all, let us write the sample space of the given experiment. Now here we have tossed a coin 3 times. Now remember, when a coin is tossed n times, the number of elements in sample space is 2 raised to power n. Now here, the coin is tossed 3 times, so number of elements in sample space is equal to 2 raised to power 3, which is equal to 8. Now when we toss a coin 3 times, then we get these outcomes, that is getting all heads. Now here H denote head and T denote tail. Then getting exactly 2 heads. Now here we have the outcome HHT, it means we can get exactly 2 heads and 1 tail. Now here we also have head in the first toss, in the second toss we can have tail, in the third toss we can have head again. Then the other outcome is THH. The next outcome can be THH. Then the next outcome THT. Then the next outcome, which is HTT. Then next outcome, that is TTT, means getting all tails. It means here the total number of elements in sample space is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 and 8. So the sample space S can be written as a set containing these elements. Now we have event E, that is both heads and tails have occurred. Now in the sample space, the outcomes HHH and TTT have only heads or tails. Remaining elements have both heads and tails. So leaving these two outcomes, rest belong to event E. So event E is a set containing elements HHT, HTH, THH, TTH, THT and HTT. So number of outcomes, or we can say number of elements in event E, is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. Now probability P of an event E is equal to number of elements favorable to event E upon total number of elements in sample space S. Now, total number of elements in sample space S is equal to 8 and number of elements in event E is 6. So this is equal to 6 upon 8, which is equal to 3 upon 4. Thus, probability P of an event E is equal to 3 upon 4. Now, event F is at most one tail has occurred. It means maximum. There should be one tail or less than one tail. It means we will have outcomes having no tail or outcomes having one tail only. Now, HHH has no tail, so it belongs to event F. Then outcomes HHT, HTH and THH have one tail only, so they also belong to event F. So, number of elements in event F is equal to 1, 2, 3 and 4. Thus, probability P of event F is equal to number of elements favorable to event F, that is 4, upon total number of elements in sample space S, that is 8. And this is equal to 1 upon 2. Now we have to show that events E and F are independent. Now from the key idea, we know that two events A and B are independent if probability of event A intersection B is equal to probability of event A into probability of event B. Now here we have to prove that E and F are independent events. It means here we have to show that probability P of event E intersection F is equal to probability of event E into probability of event F. Now first of all, let us find event E intersection F. It will include those elements which are in event E as well as in event F. So from the event E and event F, we see that HTH, THH and HHT are common to both the events. Thus, event E intersection F is a set containing elements HHT, HTH and THH. So here we can see that number of elements in event E intersection F is equal to 3. So probability P of event E intersection F is equal to number of elements favorable to event E intersection F, that is 3, upon total number of elements in sample space S, that is 8. So probability of event E intersection F is 3 upon 8. Now let us find probability of event E into probability of event F. which is equal to, now probability of event E is 3/4 and probability of event F is 1/2. So this is equal to 3/4 into 1/2, which is equal to 3/4 into 2, that is 8. Thus, probability of event E intersection F is equal to probability of event E into probability of event F. Therefore, events E and F are independent events. So this is the solution of the given question, and that's all for this session. Hope you all have enjoyed the session.